7:45 and she's just flown home to her bedsit that enshrines her bold activity. Her makeup due to rain is now running down her feet, but there's no shame for the magpie with an ever-growing nest. But the room is getting smaller as her swag is getting bigger. As she lays down her goal, she starts scratching at her hand, and the claw causes pain, and in time will cause the bleed. And the latent bird spreads her schizophrenic wings. She starts to cry, she starts to call, she starts to cry, she starts to call, and advances plans for nighttime as she's sleeping in the daytime. As the dust gathers heavy on the loot that must have been pillaged 20 years ago, if not 30, if not 40, it questions on one's mind just how long it could well be before the room becomes a treasure chest of archaeology. And leaning more towards the point, will she be here to see that day? She wakes after day from a restless, cautious sleep, and her eyes are infrared as the check will now begin of the inventory of this glitzy contrabandist. As she picks up right away that crap against a former on a vase that came from 1285 Albert Springle Road. As the lights begin to fade in London town, she now repairs as she wrenches on a stocking with it catching on her claw and spreads her arms, which are wings which she never had before. And her chest expands to its full extent. She turns her face into the wind. The magpie takes a flight and cycles round and round and round and round and round. Down this quiet road, she studied days and end. The timing seems to write, her feathers twitch, and now begins the show. As though she falls right down into her knees and looks around, and there he is, the man who lives at 42. She knows he lives alone, and so the magpie goes inside with him to bathe her minor injuries. As he searches for a bandage whilst concealing his erection, the old bird downstairs that surely would have more than just a plaster puts her teeth into a watch that caught her eye. She takes the carrot and embedding this along with 50 pounds inside the small, she takes her flashes on the move. He's unaware, but still upstairs. As she makes her way into a nest, another goal attention, sir, to think that open windows happen here and now this day and age, and cliching her to that dog that stares at his reflection in some river made of bigger bones. This house is made of bigger bones and birds much more than dogs and shameless kleptomaniacs. As the slippery bird begins this apparent free for all, the stirring sound triggers the wind to start to stick, start to rise, and the aged bear appears but drops a stick in muted fear as the rising bird is screaming in a not so muted fear. She launches, she attacks, she cries and claws and pecks and paralyzes. 7:45 and she's just flown home, where her bedsit that enshrines her bold activity, shot in blue flashing lights that illuminate the room. And the magpie cries out louder as the knocks and doors get louder, and the shrilling squawking noises come as soon as the door is broken in. As Mrs. Janet Gordon fails to recognise her name, she seems to chew her wrist and look around as if to start the check. And yes, the crack is getting bigger on the abbot's very vase, and stand these visitors before her, they're the first for 20 years. She feels a sense of pride showing that she spreads her feathered arms.